Okay.
I'm going to do a Celtic Cross. I watched Vincent. His link is on my YouTube channel. And you should check him out. He's great. And his favorite spread is the Celtic Cross. He's been doing it for 30 years, so he's quite proficient, and he's developed his own way of reading the Celtic Cross. And he shares his opinion with us, his thoughts, and it's very helpful. I'm just learning the tarot, so the Celtic Cross is something I think you develop. The more you do, the better you get at it. So it's important to just keep doing it, and the cards teach you as you do them, and put them in positions and all that. So what I did is under his latest video, he talked about the positions again, and I wrote them in these little cards. So I'm going to put them down. It's almost, I think sometimes when you buy tarot, they have like a card spread and it's a piece of plastic. So you could use those as well, but this is something I'm going to use with these cards. And I'm just going to try again. I'm doing another Celtic cross. Try to fit it on here. The cards are bigger, so I'm not sure how that's going to work. But the more you angle them, the more you can kind of get them in, I think, get them in the visual field. So I'm putting them in how he reads this. So now this five is over here. Four and six. So now the other thing I'm going to do today, which is a little kind of wild and crazy, is I'm going to use a deck that's not, that is more, I can read more intuitively, and that's the John Bauer deck. It's a charming deck, and I really like this deck. So I'm going to see what I can do with this deck as far as reading a Celtic Cross for myself. This is going to be a challenge. Because I'm doing the Celtic Cross, I'm also going to be looking. I'm going to be looking at the pictures, as well as the suits and the numbers. But I'm going to be looking at the pictures to see how that is for me as far as reading. So we have the positions underneath these little squares are what the positions mean, according to Vincent. So this is going to be like a little cheat sheet for myself. So I'm just going to lay the cards down. I need a question though. Oh yeah, that's the idea. I need a question. So what's my question? Like, let's say, how can I be successful reading the tarot? How can I be successful reading the tarot? How can I be successful reading the tarot? Okay, so I'm just gonna start laying down the cards. The Six of Swords. Ace of Pentacles, that's what that is. It took me time to figure this out one that figure this out. Okay, over here. Two of Swords. I'm getting a lot of sword energy here. Yeah, these cards are kind of big, but that's okay. I'm just gonna put them. Not to worry too much about how they look now because I can pull them out. I can pull them to see them as I talk about them. Now, one of the things that I also have a very small table. Okay, one of the things I did with previous reading of the Celtic Cross is kind of to look it over first, go from general to specific and see what I have. Just a quick look at it. I have three cups. That's emotions. I have three sword energies. I have no major arcana. I have three pentacles, four pentacles. No, Wait. Pentacle, wand, one pentacle, three cups. And four pentacles. I think this is pentacles. I don't know what this one is. Do they have pictures in here? I think it's a pentacle. Ace of, oh, it doesn't have pictures. Oh. Houston, we got a problem. Unless it's the magician. Ew. Now, what would make this... This is a problem. I'm not sure what this card is. And there's no pictures in this thing. Okay, it says it. This is the magician. The three dark birds perch on the shoulder, neck, and head of a creature kneeling on the ground. The creature looks out to their right. A hand rests on the hilt of a blade. Yeah, it's right here. Meanings, assessing the situation, knowing the right moment to strike, being guided by a higher hand, self-control. Okay, so... this is my question, and I have sort of defines the question. So it's we have the Six of Swords. That's where the person is going out into the water, trying something new. And then here we have the Magician. So it really does sum up my quest for learning how to do the tarot. I already forgot what the question was. Something like, how can I be successful reading the tarot? Well, I think I'm sort of in the right track because I have the interest in doing it, and I have some guidance from the magician. The magician is making something out of nothing. So, and how I just read that, it shows that I'm in the right direction. So, these are all good. This is good. It's an intellectual pursuit, and it's also working with the magician. So that's a good thing. Now, this top card is, right now I'm just cursory going through it. This is the Two of Swords. The Two of Swords, of course, is when you have an option of what to do. And this is my current action. My current action is making a decision to do something, making a decision, wondering which way to go. I haven't made the decision yet, but I'm sort of weighing the consequences of things, weighing my options. And that's what I'm currently doing. So I'm working, and this is, again, intellectually, I'm working with trying to figure out how to do this successfully. And if you see the picture, it's a funny picture, not a funny picture, but it's a man trying to slay the dragon. So it's kind of like I'm willing, and I don't know if I'm able, but I'm willing to take on this charge of learning the tarot. You know, I don't really know why I'm doing this, I have to say. I have a curiosity about the tarot. I don't really know where it's going to take me, if it's going to take me anywhere. But I like, I never knew what the tarot was until I started doing research and started doing this back in September, which is not that long ago, really, 8 months ago. Well, not even 8 months ago, 6 months ago. I didn't know what it was, and when I realized, I started learning more and more about it. I got more intrigued, more interested, and more charmed by the whole thing. So the John Bauer, he's got these great pictures. These are paintings by John Bauer, I think, at the turn of the century. So he's ready to slay the dragon. And I see that as myself, trying to slay, trying to break the code, trying to figure out what this is all about. You know, it's an Elfie moment. That's what it is. It's an Elfie moment. There's a song in the 60s. What's it all about, Elfie? So I have these two cards that are very supportive of my, you know, it sort of describes my question, where I'm confused, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm willing to tackle it, and I'm willing to go forward, and I have magical powers, and I think it is magical powers to do tarot correctly, or to do it, you know, give it justice. Okay, now here we have intention. My intention is the Seven of Swords. The Seven of Swords is intention. The Seven of Swords. It's kind of scary, isn't it? But let's look at the picture. Now here's this knight going forward with his sword. He's going into these clouds. It's showing a road here, and it goes up through the clouds to a palace or a castle up there. So my intention is to somehow get this knowledge and learn from it and share it. I mean, that's why I have a YouTube channel, is to share what I learn to other people who are interested. I mean, I know I'm not the best teacher because I'm just learning myself, but I think there's some value in that as I move along on my trek. And here I am. My intention is to learn more, is to move forward, and I'm going into clouds. I mean, I don't know everything. I know very, very little, but I think what I am getting a sense with the tarot is it's endless. I mean, it's not something you learn, okay, here's the book, you learn it, read the book, and this is for this and this is for that, and there's a two of swords and there's one cup, and this was this meaning and that's that meaning. I don't think it works like that. I mean, I'm getting more and more a sense of it is there's a lot of intuition involved, and it's a lot of intuitive thinking, a lot of creative thinking, and that's what intrigues me the most, I think. I am taking the action to try to crack the nut, and I am still I'm very much interested in doing this, and my intention is to go forward and to learn more about not just the tarot. I mean, I think I'm approaching the tarot from a subconscious, I'm very tuned into subconscious thinking, or the importance of subconscious thinking, and it's hidden knowledge, it's below the surface. But I think cards and card reading can help. You can help learn more about yourself, learn more about the world. It's almost like a meditation. It's a way of getting below the surface where you can't get, you can't really think it out, or even, it's hard. So if you have images, or you have you thinking of nothing, there's more. You have a way of accessing inner knowledge or subconscious knowledge. And what that does is then it just makes you be more aware of what's going on around you, even though you're never going to know everything. So a lot of people do this in different ways, but I don't know. I think I do meditate a lot, so that's sort of where I'm coming from, and that's sort of where my interest is in tarot. Okay, so I have that going on, and that's a good thing. This is my here is my asset, what I bring to the table to help me achieve my goal of being successful at reading tarot, and it's the Five of Cups. Five of Cups is the nostalgia card, but it's also an innocence, and it's a love of innocent of the past, a love of the past, a childlike interest in something, which I do have. I mean, when you tell people you're reading the tarot, they roll their eyes like, "What are you doing? I mean, what are you doing that for? What a waste of your time and energy and whatever." And I think it's because people are just sort of ingrained in their own thinking, and they get old and they get sort of stuck, and they don't have a vision, or they don't have the desire to see if there's more to learn. And so I think I am approaching this with innocence and openness, which, like, as a child, I'm not coming in here with, I mean, I was raised in a Catholic religion. I've sort of left that by the wayside. I'm a spiritual person. I'm into spirituality, so I'm approaching this from a very with a childlike curiosity and interest, and that is an asset for sure. I think anything you approach like that is good, no matter what it is. If it's any kind of, painting or writing or anything you do, if you approach it with childlike innocence, I think you're kind of ahead of the game. I think you'll keep going. I think if you're not with childlike innocence, you're too quick to say, if someone says something like, "You don't know what you're doing," you're saying, "Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing," then you give up. or, you know, that's a stupid thing to do. And you'll say, yeah, I'm not going to do that anymore. With a childlike innocence, you don't care what people say. You don't care what people think. You just keep going forward because, you know, it's something you're going to do. You know, you want to play in a mud pile, you're going to play in some mud, you're going to play in some mud. You just like doing that. People can't argue with you. Okay, so then this one is opportunities. So what opportunities are presenting themselves to me? It's the Ten of Cups. Ten of Cups is, of course, success and, you know, a lot of people getting together, families. I mean, Ten of Cups is like just a lot of success, love. I mean, being in a community that does it is good. So that could be an opportunity for me. So we have the Ten of Cups, celebration. It's being with other people. And I talked about this a lot in my other videos, and, you know, it's more my personal life. It's like I plan on going to the farmer's market this year, and I will be talking about the tarot to other people as I meet them because it's fun. It's a fun thing to do, and maybe I can encourage them to come to my barn and have some readings, and maybe having supportive people around you is nice, and that's what I want to encourage. I did, when I started tarot, I had a home study group, and it was a lot of fun. I did it for 8 weeks. And so I try to encourage people to look into it. And I do talk about tarot. I don't want to bore people, you know, but I do talk about tarot to other people because I didn't know anything about it. And when I found out what it was, which what I take away from it, it is the fool's journey, which is all of our journeys. That sort of like just kind of crystallized everything for me and just made it so much more interesting. So I think I have a lot of strengths here. In fact, I see a lot of positive things. I don't see any negativity here at all. I'm currently trying to tame the beast. I brought with me the magic and the beginnings, using my intellect and the journey. I'm here now where I've approached something. I see the little more intricacies of it and how it's a big topic, but I'm willing to take it on with childlike interest and curiosity. And I have a community, and as long as I work on the community, that's probably also not only here, there's not a huge community here, but, you know, talking to people about it. And then also the community online. I do follow other tarot readers, and I have started, obviously, this YouTube channel, so that's good. Now, this card here refers to the question, and it's how I feel about the question. And here we have I don't know who this is. There's a this is another Major Arcana, I believe. No, this is the Queen of Pentacles. The Queen of Pentacles. And here she is. I'm pretty sure it's the Queen of Pentacles. And here's the Pentacle, here's the Queen. So the Queen of Pentacles, or the Princess, it may be the Princess, I don't know. I'm not going to look it up because it's unnecessary. I think I just want to look at the card to see what the card tells me. So here I am sitting. I like to think of myself as one of this person as opposed to one of these people. I don't know. I just think it's cool. So here she is. Here I am sitting on some rocks in the forest. Light is coming out of me. That's kind of nice. And so my view of the question is one of enlightenment. I mean, I want to learn. So I feel very positive about the question. I think the question is important to me. And I'm looking for enlightenment. I'm finding enlightenment in the question. I'm going through this journey with learning the tarot because I feel like I just have a sense, an intuitive sense, that it's going to take me somewhere. And I don't know about, I'm not talking about money or fame or fortune or anything like that. I just think personally it's going to take me somewhere. And I don't know where that is, but I think I'm going to get something out of it because I'm already getting things out of it. So it's just going to continue. And so it's a form of enlightenment. It's a form of learning, intuitive learning that I'm getting from it. And that's how I see the question, and that's how I see myself. This is the time frame. It's the Two of Wands. The Two of Wands is starting to get ready. It's making a plan to move forward. And that's where I am. I am, on the beginning of the journey. I'm looking out to see what's going on. I haven't gone out there yet. I'm not on that particular path, but I'm taking it under consideration. I'm moving forward. So I'm not going gung ho, but I am thinking and considering and about ready to move forward even faster. But it's going to be a process. It's not going to happen. I'm not in the middle of running towards it quickly. I'm still in the thinking phase. Four, it's the purpose. Now, I mentioned the purpose before. Here's this girl, this Four of Cups. And she looks, seeing the Four of Cups as someone who's disappointed. I don't see her as being disappointed. I see her as looking inward. The purpose of all this is to learn more about myself and learn more about more than myself, learning more about the collective consciousness or my subconscious, or learning more about greater things. And I do feel like that knowledge is in within all of us, but we have to access it. There's different ways of accessing it. So the purpose of this is to learn more about myself and about hidden things that are hidden to all of us. It's not just about me, it's about the communal aspect to this, to learning about the collective consciousness or whatever. So that's the purpose. And then this is the Five of Swords. Now, wait a minute, did I get the five confused with the, no, the five. The five are the details, the expectations, and how you fine-tune everything. Okay, so this is the one, interestingly enough, this is where there's some change, there's some, not strife, but there's some activity needed, some action needed, and it's going to be something that's throws you off balance. Now, I don't see that anywhere in the other cards. Anywhere. I just see it in this card where something is and I think maybe that what it means to me actually, what I'm thinking now is it's not all sweetness and light. It's doing the hard work. It's being, having some critical thinking, developing some critical thinking. I think we all think of the tarot and everything like all it's all sort of, intuitive and imaginative, and I mean I think that too. But there is some critical thinking involved with doing the tarot, and this is something that I mean I'm a very much of a critical thinker, but and I think that's one why I'm interested in the tarot, because it's a little different. But I think you should come to it with some critical thinking, especially if it's part of your nature. So as time goes on, I'll see the finer points to this. Right now, it's sort of a global exercise. I see everything more globally, and maybe in time, I'll be able to pick out the nuances better. The intricacies more, and that'll be a good thing. That'll be a very good thing. So that's the details, looking at the details of these cards. So at right now they look very they're very kind of general, but there's specificity here that I need to focus on. Like he's slaying the dragon. It's the Two of Swords, focus more. Well, that's just the what is this? This is the current actions. So think about that. I should need to think about that a little bit more, how I'm going to do that. What does that mean? Like, how does that happen? How do you cut to the core of things? What things do I have to do to cut to the core? I mean, I can just make videos and just talk generally, but I have to be specific. And so that's something to think about. And in everything I do, there should be specific ways of dealing with things. specific. Be specific. I'm going to leave this and think more about this, but I am going to turn the video camera off because I'm going to leave this out for the day and think about this, what this card says about the details, and consider this layout. Now the question was, how can I be successful in reading the tarot? And I want to look more at specifics and see what I come up with. So anyways, that's my reading of Celtic Cross with the John Bauer. As I said, I put these little notices of what each card, the positions of the cards, what they mean. I know, I think that's helpful. I'm sure after I do about 5 or 6 of these, I won't have to put these little cards down below. I'll know what they are. So it's something to consider. Go and watch Vincent Pizzici. I killed the name probably. And look at his videos and make your little cards up and do yourself some Celtic crosses. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.